you know, I got to a point where I was doing drugs. 2013, I was doing so much drugs because I wanted to die. And that's kind of fucked up, but it's the truth. You know what I mean? I did want to die. 2013, I hated my life.
Oh, he's doing it again. Okay. The carbonated urine in a martini glass this time. What is that?
Danny gives me a different single serving of Red Bull for every show. Today it's been served in a martini glass.
And that's your second one of the day.
It's my second one. It's just a serving size.
Are you worried the caffeine's going to do something to you?
What's it going to do to me?
Caffeine's not good. Caffeine's not great.
Not going to grow a third arm.
That's true, I think.
She brings it to me in glasses that are meant for alcoholics, which I hate to say.
Yeah, why do we not have a... What about the cans? Oh, because no food brand deals?
No, no, no. I think she sees it as an opportunity for comedy.
Oh, it's funny.
Look, Martini
oh,
yeah. Glass. And how funny is it that we're sober for fucking almost 6 months now?
And by the way, it's going great thus far. It's going great. Danny's a comedian now, apparently. Yeah, sober life's going great. For those of you who joined us on this journey, I ran into one kid. He was driving. I'm just going to say, he's a nut, dude. And he comes to sports rehab and he always yells at me in his car. He's like, Impaulsive! I'm like, yo, easy. And he's like, oh man, I did the sober challenge with you guys. And he's like, I made it 2 days. And then,
whatever.
And then he quit.
I mean, by the way, dope, dude. Are we fucking losers?
For being sober?
Yeah.
You know, the only reason why I'll say maybe is because you know when you're in like the lit phase of your life and you're at a party, everyone's turning up and you go to offer someone a shot and they're like, no, no, I'm sober.
Sober.
And you, I mean, let's be honest. You're like, yo, this dude's a fucking pussy. Or like, this person sucks. And that's us now.
It is. And I think about that all the time because I think about being at the club and I got like a bottle of Ace or even some 42 and I'm one girl. And then I get to the fourth girl and she's like, no, no, none for me, sir. And I'm like, what's good? Why are you here then? And now I'm that fucking girl, dude.
Yeah. It's okay. It's good. It's healthy.
Hey, but quickly to touch on it, it's great. I'm fucking riding my bike at 8 in the morning. Been having fucking great sex.
That's not true. Bro, I train at 8 in the morning. Where have you been? Has he been doing it? Whoa.
One day. Wow. I'd say I've been doing it.
Yeah, I've been training for something.
Yeah, what are you training for? You can't say, right?
No, I can't say yet. But yo, the bagel guy, you know the bagel guy, the short bagel guy who freaked out? Yeah. He called me out on Twitter. Yeah. He said, first Logan Paul tells TMZ he'd fight me. Soon after he ghosts. Now I'm hearing Jake Paul has something to say about me as well. These two are world-class pussy boys. Stop talking shit about me to other people, you cowards. Yo, has anyone seen this dude fight? He is legitimate. Like, I hate... Yo, you could be short and still be dope, but you're making yourself less dope when you're just saying stupid shit. He's like 4'11". I think I saw something like he's trying to get like a UFC fight. Dog, you need to calm down.
By the time
I'm telling this to you as a friend, you are gonna get hurt. He just got bodied at a casino in Vegas. Like, you need to ease up, bagel guy.
By the time this episode comes out, even tomorrow, there already will be a bunch of responses from you because I know you've been showing me your responses you've been working on. But also, like, is this not the biggest example of like that new age route to success that you've ever seen? Like, you saw it with Dr. Phil and Bahad Bahabi.
Yeah.
Now you see it with the fucking next guy. Now bagel dude is trying to go pop culture and shit.
It's not working for him because no one's taking him seriously.
Yeah, but that was the same way for Bahad Bahabi at first, bro.
Oh, this dude could become a rapper?
Hell yeah, bro.
That's fire.
Yes, bro. Of course.
Maybe I'll fight him. There's another thing I was going to mention. The Band-Aid's still on my face. Still got this rash. It'll go away, I think. We have a pretty charged episode coming on Monday. We shot it before this one. Just be ready. Here's the warning. The disclaimer is that it's very, very highly opinionated, and the opinions from our guests do not reflect our opinions. And I think we made that clear in the episode, but I do want to say that now in case the media land tries to backfire on us a little bit. And by the way, like, I'm done being attacked. Like, I'm a snap back. I'm a snap back if anything happens.
You did great, bro. Oh, you did great. You took a very neutral stance on it, which, by the way, is your stance. So what I love when he does is he's not taking a neutral stance. He's taking his stance. Your stance is open, but we're going to be nice to our fucking guests. I threatened to punch Alex Jones in the face. I don't want to do that shit anymore. I don't want to punch my guest.
Can you imagine if you did that?
Like,
you
probably, I would have got 100K.
You probably should have done it, bro. Our ratings would have gone up.
He told me to, and then he came over and punched himself.
Savage. Yeah.
Crazy episode.
Subscribe to see that episode. It's coming Monday. We're going to do an audio-only extended Q&A with the guest after today. That's not even true, though, because he's performing. Guys, our guest today, his family made their way to the States as refugees when he was a child, and today he's blowing up as an artist. The New York Times called the Trap Phil Collins. You may have heard his tracks like My Year featuring G-Eazy and Creep on Me featuring French Montana and DJ Snake. And his new single, Safety, off his upcoming album is out now. He'll be performing it later today here on Impaulsive. Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome Gashi.
Let's go.
This gonna be my year. This gonna be my year. This my year. This gonna be my year. This gonna be my year. My year. My year.
Let's go.
My guy.
Yeah.
My guy.
Yeah. What up?
Hey, I fucking love this song.
Man. Yeah, I can put my headphones on.
Yeah, yeah.
All right.
Oh. How's it sound? You probably sound great. You're an artist.
Yo, what up, man?
Must be nice, dog. How you doing?
Oh my God.
New York.
First of all, thank you for having me.
Of course, bro.
That's crazy, man. My year is never getting old, huh?
I love it. I'm obsessed with it. Like, I bump it in my car.
I mean, how could you not be obsessed with it? So the message is positive as fuck.
Yeah, but
bro,
what if you have a shit year, dog? Like, I never played that song once.
Then you play it before the next year.
You know what sucks? I got Soulja Boy on the remix for my year, and as soon as it dropped, he went to jail. And it was the worst. It was the worst. Like, see, like, certain people that play the record, it either goes or it goes the opposite way. So you got to be careful.
Soulja Boy did a remix?
Yeah, and then he went to jail like the next day. And
you,
like,
I mean, but do you still believe in Soulja Boy musically?
Yes. Really? I love Soulja Boy.
How come?
Because like he people try to like say that he's like a one-hit wonder. But like how many hits has Soulja Boy put out?
A lot, actually. Yeah.
You understand what I'm saying?
But it was so long ago.
I know, but they still go, man.
Those songs do. I'm saying, like, now, today.
Well,
do you think he still got it? Because I wonder if his style, like, marked a certain time in a period in time.
I don't know, man. I can't answer that. I don't know. But I'm just a Soulja Boy fan. Man.
I got you.
You know what I mean? I love him. And going back to the My Year thing, man, like when Raptors won the championship, they played it on the float.
And, how'd that feel?
It felt amazing. You know, I was home just watching the TV because I'm always just watching TV with my boxers eating cereal at the box.
That's the life.
Yeah, you know, I'm just living regular.
Wait, super important question. What cereal exactly?
Apple Jacks.
All right.
Or right. Fruity Pebbles. Fruity Pebbles.
Yeah, for sure. I love
the answer Pebbles. We were looking for was...
We all know.
Cinnamon Toast Crunch. Okay, cinnamon that's the answer we were looking too. For. Yeah, but Apple Jacks is fine, dude. Healthy alternative.
It's cinnamon still.
And it's apples.
Yeah, it's still apples.
Yep. Made of apples and cinnamon. That's it.
So, I mean, you have a fuckload of songs. That's definitely my favorite.
I appreciate that.
When you were making it, was this before you knew it was going to be your year? Because it sort of is happening now.
Yeah, it's crazy, man. Like, I put that song out and my life changed. Like, in a weird way.
It's manifestation.
Yeah,
because, like, you know, we were driving and it was cold as shit. Am I allowed to curse on here?
Yeah, cool. Bro.
It was cold as fuck.
There you go. Let's go.
And I was driving with my dad and Mariah Carey was playing. He's like, yo, man, this song comes on every Christmas. And I was like,
Oh, yeah.
I was like, this bitch charts the Billboard charts every Christmas. So I was like, yo. And then he goes, who got a New Year song? Because, like, me being Albanian, like, we don't really celebrate Christmas. Like,
okay.
My dad was like, yo, do they have a New Year song? And I was like, man, they don't have a New Year song.
Yeah.
So I was like, yo, I should make a New Year song so they could play me when I die. And I chart.
Sick.
So I made My Year. And then originally I was supposed to have Offset on it and G-Eazy. Something happened with Offset and G-Eazy. We became super close. That's my homie. And he did the verse, send it back. My manager's best friends with his manager and... It happened, cool. And we put it out, and everyone's like the women's soccer team just won championship. They celebrated with my song.
Ah, tight.
So everyone's celebrating with my song, and it just feels super dope because it's like everyone's like I was at the hockey game, and it came on. Everybody's turning up like celebrating to it, but nobody really knew it was mine.
Well, hey, why is that? Because fuck, bro, I'm gonna be honest with you. When they're like, "Yo, gosh, he's gonna come out and perform," I was like, "All right, let me check out his music."
Yeah.
And that song came up. I'm like, why did I not connect the dots?
Wasn't that usually the case? Like, sometimes you hear a song before you know who to attribute it to. You know what I'm saying?
I mean, I have a few songs that everyone knows, but like some people know me by my face and some people don't, you know? And that's why I'm on this podcast.
Let's go.
Hey, true. But bro, you're wearing sunglasses and a hat.
I know.
I'm with the glass.
But you know, but like at the same time, it's like, bro, like, I've been doing this for like 10 years. Like, this is not how I always am. If you go on my Instagram, and I always switch it up. I feel like, you know what I mean? It's very David Bowie too. Like, by the time people catch the first style, I switch it up. You know what I mean? I switch it up a lot. But the thing is, it's not even about that, man. I feel like I haven't really got the plan or marketing myself. I just put music out and kind of stay behind scenes. And
intentionally, is that how you create, or would you like to get a bit more maybe strategic with the way you're marketing yourself?
I mean, you know, the Gashi before would be like, fuck this podcast. I'm not doing it.
I mean,
you know, now the Gashi, now
it's like, bro, that's in the world.
And now it's like, now it's like, oh, Logan Paul, like, man.
That dude's like a bitch.
No, every like,
I get it.
No, like every person that speaks of anything that's like popping right now. It's like you, your brother, and a bunch of shit.
Okay.
So it's like, okay, cool. Like that should help me. You know what I mean? And I think that I'm upcoming. I'm pretty tight, I would think. And a lot of kids like me. So it's only right that I come to a cool podcast, you know, and I wouldn't do any podcast, you know?
Yeah.
So I did this one. I thought this one would be cool. And the old me would be like, no, because it's just like, fuck it. I'm not doing anything.
Interesting.
The new me is like, yo, let's just do it. Fuck it. What can I lose? You know, I did Gary V.
Oh, you did?
Nice.
Yeah. I did the Gary V thing. He used my song for a while for his thing. But there's a lot of things about me people don't know. You know, I was like one of the first artists in New York to do a song with Nipsey Hussle. Everyone's like such a like a clout chaser, like on another man's death. It's like I was just sitting back watching everyone post that they did a song with him first, and I was just like, what the hell?
Yeah.
Like,
yeah.
If you do your history, 2009, 2010, I was the first artist to do original song with Nipsey.
Damn, a decade ago?
Yeah.
Wow. Yeah. Oh, 2009?
He made me drop out of school. Like, he was like, yo, you're so dope, you should drop out.
And Nipsey Hussle convinced you to drop out of school?
Yeah, so I dropped out. So that's how my career really started, because I dropped out. I had a full scholarship to play football.
Well, we got a title for the video.
Yeah, for real.
Nipsey Hussle Command.
Yeah.
Yo, you're the first New York rapper on the show, which to me holds so much importance. How old are you?
Well, I'm not a rapper.
Okay.
Elaborate.
Like if you listen to my songs, like Creep on Me, it's like 100 million plays, platinum, right? That's a singing song. I'm not rapping on it.
Yeah.
My new song, Safety, that's about to go platinum already. It's not.
What would you call yourself then?
I'm an artist, man. I don't rap. Like, if you listen to the music, I don't just rap all day.
What's the style of This My Ears, that specific song? Because that's like to me, I would consider that like hype rap.
Yeah. That's called fun music. You know what I'm saying? Like, when I did that shit, I was having fun, man. Like, I'm singing on it. Like, I'm singing on it. Sing rapping on it. Like, I feel like rapping is like what Kendrick does. J. Cole. Like, these
are... So you're really giving credit to the true rappers.
Real rappers. Okay, I can't take that away from the real rapper. Like, they sit there, they write bar for bar, and like what they do is super poetic. And what I do is fun. I sing, I do melodies, and I'm an international artist. So I make music for people who don't understand what I'm saying, but feel my melodies and get the chills when they hear it. Because you guys got to also understand, I was born in Africa, right?
Yeah, I wanted to talk to you about this. You have a crazy story.
Yeah, it's a little fucked up. Like, I was born in Africa because my country was at war. My parents had to leave Kosovo, right? They go there. I'm born with my sister. Now, I'm in an Arabic country, Gaddafi. This shit's crazy. I don't understand what's going on. I don't look like anybody around me. And now I have to go to school. I'm getting attacked every day, getting bullied, beat up every single day. I go to class, I come out, getting beat up again. It's like, that's the thing that was happening my entire childhood, not saying anything to my parents. Going home, sitting there, watching Michael Jackson on TV every single day. Wanted to be Michael. And then my parents say, we're leaving here. Pack up, and we hit the road. Small car. For the first time ever, I hear Gangsta's Paradise on the radio.
Coolio.
Yeah. I'm like, wow, this is different from Michael. You know, and I see music as an escape for everything that I'm going through. So as I travel, because this is a long story short, as I travel, my parents decided to try to find a way to America, and any way they can get here, they're trying to find a way. So
I don't want to say too much information on how we got here, but we got here. You know, they're putting kids in cages now. I'm not trying to. I'm too big to fit in one. Yeah.
They'll get but, one. They'll make one.
Yeah.
They'll make, one.
Yeah, but you know, that's why. That's why I kind of like to not to like cut myself off, but like you know, that's why I like what's going on. It's a little fucked up, and I feel it when I see it. I feel like I relate to it. You know what I mean? I am an immigrant. I did come to America. I was forced to change my name. You know, my real name is Labanon, but they changed it to Larry.
Will you ever make music or you know, any kind of art that would touch on those subjects?
Yeah,
I
do make music. Yeah, if you listen to my first kind of mixtapes before I had a deal, I would touch on that. I always tell my story. But nowadays, it's like, there's a new artist every Friday, bro.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
Nobody got time to hear your story. Nobody really cares. So just say it a little bit and move forward.
I don't think they care until they're given a solid reason to care. Like I feel like you could definitely be an artist that pops up out of nowhere. Everyone's like, who the fuck is this kid? Where did he come from? And meanwhile, you've been doing this shit for what, 2+ decades now.
Yeah.
And the overnight success story is 10 to 20,000 hours of hard work.
It's trash, man. I hate it, man. Like, so many times, like, I'll go on stage and then, like, I'll come out and then somebody will say some stupid shit like, oh, we have another Post Malone. And I have to jump off stage, punch him in the face.
Oh, shit.
Like, I have to jump off stage, punch him in the mouth, show ends. You know what I'm saying?
have you done that?
Yeah, plenty of times.
You jump off stage and punch someone?
All the time. Go on YouTube.
Shut up.
Yeah. So, like,
is it really on YouTube?
Check it. It probably is. If it's not, just be like, Gashi, like, curses fans or smacks fans or goes in. I'll probably give you something off my phone.
So you snap back?
Yeah, I usually do all the time.
Gashi punching people, boxing comes up.
Recently, I just did a show in Kosovo, which is my country. You guys know Dua Lipa?
Yeah, of course.
So she had me out there do a show with Calvin Harris and Miley.
I saw a picture of you guys.
Yeah.
So how'd that work?
Yeah, I love her, man. She's so amazing. She's from the same place I'm from. And
she's Albanian?
Yeah, she is.
Oh, sick.
So she had me do a show and the show was going great, but then I jumped into the crowd and somebody ripped my chain off.
Trying to snatch it or by accident?
Like, you know, they love me. So they were like hugging me and like the chain came off. And I was like so pissed off that this is my fault. I turned around, I was like, you bitch, da, 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 da. And I went off. And it was my fault. Like, I shouldn't have reacted that way. Mm-hmm. But sometimes you get caught up.
Yeah, hell yeah.
Like, bro, you know, you fight, whatever. You do, like, sports and stuff. Like, you're not thinking when you're doing it. You're just in there. You're a beast. You're an animal. And that's what happens. Like, I don't remember, like, being on stage. Like, I don't remember shit. Like, I go on stage, and it's like I'm a total different soul.
Sober? Or?
Yeah, I'm sober. I'll pop Zans on the plane because I hate flying. But, like, besides that, like, I'm pretty sober.
You punch people with those rings?
Yeah.
Shut the fuck up.
But yo, look, but like, that's not what I'm about. I just feel like when people say stupid shit like, oh, Post Malone, or like they'll yell like another fat white artist. Like, not fat cool either, because I'm a fat fuck. But what I'm saying is like when they yell at another fat artist, it's like, bro, like I've been doing this shit for so fucking long.
Yeah.
Like, get off my dick.
So
like,
would you be more comfortable with that, with like Post Malone as the next you, as vice versa?
No.
Because like, people call me Adam Sandler and I'm chill with it. I'm Adam Sandler's one of the best comedians time. But by the way, Post Malone's on fire right now.
Yeah, I don't care. I don't care about that. It's just like the whole, like, people need to compare you to someone for acceptance.
For sure.
You understand? like, and shout out to Post, man. Like, you know what I'm saying? Like, I knew him way before.
Yeah.
Like, the, everything.
But
happened.
They're doing it to be assholes.
Yeah,
like, for sure.
They're just like, you know what it is? People want to say something in hopes that you get shook and you're like, fuck it, I'm not going to say anything. But then they're like, bro, like, all right, go up, let's click on the clip real quick.
Which
go
one?
Down, go down real quick. I just want to see. Let me see. Click on, go up a little bit. Right there, that one, right
this
there.
This one?
To the right, up.
This one?
Yeah,
click. Oh, shit.
Look, see that? Hold on, pause it. See that kid? That kid screamed something funny towards me.
This one?
Yeah. So I jumped off stage and got on his fucking face. And he was forced to put his arm up and act like he liked me.
But, whoa. And you're a big guy, too, so it's probably...
Yeah, and I don't want to be a tough guy, but sometimes you got to get in these people's faces. All right. Ready? Pussy.
Oh, you were yelling at him right
yep.
here.
And that's it. That's what.
Hey, that's all they want. They just want a reaction.
Yeah, but the thing is like everyone usually like comes to the shows that fucks with me, like sings along, has fun, turns up. But you always have one jerk off say something, and then they expect you. And it's and like yo, putting it out there. Like I'm making way too much money to be doing this anymore. So I'm like. I have to ignore it. And like, shout out to Lee, the publicist, like putting me on to like, yo, this is how you got to move. Mm. And it's like, I can't be doing that no more, you know? But like, man, like I've been doing this for so long and I'm finally getting recognition. Finally, you know, like, you know, everybody might not know my face, but it feels so amazing when I walk into a Starbucks and I'm in my PJs and my song's on.
Yeah, it's gotta be sick.
And the person's like giving me my whatever drink I'm getting, and then my song's on, and it's like this is amazing because I'm not getting attacked. Mm. I might get attacked at certain countries I'm in where I can't go out on the streets. I go to Switzerland, they shut the shit down.
Switzerland, yeah. What about Albania?
Yeah, go back to the drawing board. Go up a little bit. You see exactly the reactions I get. Go up.
This one?
No, up a little bit. Right there to the right, Gashi. Yeah, so this is what it's like when I'm in different countries. Okay, walk. That's what makes me happy.
Which country was this?
This is in Kosovo.
Damn. Hey, you're gonna start a riot, dog.
Yeah, so like stuff like that, like in like Switzerland, Germany, like mainly like Europe, like I get crazy love, and like even Korea, like when I'm in Korea, shit gets shuts down, like you know, and that is certain type of areas that I'm lit at, and to be honest with you, like I'm happy, dog. Like,
yeah, for sure.
You know what I mean? Like I made enough money, first check I ever got off of music, right? I waited 8 years. So let's just talk about my story for a sec. Because I know this is a podcast and you're supposed to be funny, kick the shit.
Nah, bro.
Don't have
bro,
it. Like,
let's just keep it real for a second, okay? So Gashi, full scholarship, played football.
What position, by the way?
I played slot and wideout. Didn't know the sport at all. I did theater, right? Everyone was like, yo, you weak, you're super pussy for doing theater.
That's why I didn't do theater.
Really?
I was terrified. I played sports instead. No, because like the theater kids, I don't know.
You get attacked. Yeah. You know what I mean? So I would get attacked. My girl was in theater at the time. I was like, you know what? Ain't nobody like getting the main role kissing my girl. It's not happening, right? So I was like, yo, fuck it. I joined the shit. And then before you know it, everybody was attacking me on the football team, like, yo, you big as hell and you doing theater, like play a real man sport. What's a real man sport? Football. Okay, what do I do? If you catch the football, you get a full scholarship.
That's what they said. Pretty much that's what it boils down to. Yeah, that's all you gotta do.
So the boy joined and scored 47 touchdowns.
Shut the fuck up.
47 touchdowns.
Yo, in high school?
High school. I was the kicker. I was the punter.
Yo, that's wild. The
end.
Wait, what division?
I don't know. Division? Oh, what, in college?
No, high school.
High school is like the best division in New York. I went all city. That's like top. It's all American, all state, all city. For someone who's never played a sport to go all city, all borough is like pretty lit.
Where are you from? Are you from Brooklyn?
Brooklyn, yeah. Yeah, real Brooklyn. Flatbush.
Bro, yeah. I only scored 19 touchdowns. You scored 47? Yeah. Oh, shit. I'm a pussy.
Nah. You know what? Probably in your league, like, these kids were, like, made to play football. In Brooklyn, like, come on. This ain't Texas.
Bro, Ohio, dog.
That's real. Like, Ohio's serious.
They eat wood, bro. That's for breakfast, lunch, and dinner.
That's what I'm saying. Like, fried nails and shit.
You remember Jacob Coots, Mac? They called him a manster. A man monster. He was in high school. But yeah, okay. So
it's a big deal. So yeah, man, I played football, got a full scholarship. My parents are janitors. Well, my mom was trying to get a job at the time. My dad's a janitor. And I was like, man, like I hate school as it is. Like I don't want them paying for school for something I hate. Where I would take all the like easy courses in college, like gym, jazz class, you know?
Took four gym classes.
Like, I don't know, like some weird shit like that, you know? Like I just hated school. So they paid for my school, whatever. And
Then while in college, man, I started recording on Cudi beats because I love Cudi.
Like Kanye, yeah. Not bro.
Yeah, Kanye and Cudi are like my big brothers, man. Like they raised me, you know. Like these dudes. Like this is long story short too, because I have a big brother and he put me on to like Wu-Tang and like the first CD I ever bought was DMX CD.
Yeah, I was gonna ask you how New York hip hop. Like affected you or how it like inspired you and shit. And you brought up Wu-Tang, like you're from Brooklyn. So obviously I'm sure you listen to a little bit of Biggie.
Yeah, of course, man. Like, come on, man. Like you had to, The thing was, I was like Michael Jackson. I'm a dance. I want to do moonwalk. I want to do this. I want to be Prince. I wanted to be Prince.
Yeah.
And then out of nowhere we came to Brooklyn and it was kind of crazy. Cause like we went to the beach for the first time and I was wearing a Speedo. Right. And
In Brooklyn. And what beach is it?
Brighton Beach, yeah, or Coney Island.
Yeah, yeah.
My mom would put us with Speedos. And it was like a European thing.
Oh, shit.
And, bro.
Oh, no.
The Brooklyn boys don't play.
Every kid is like, what are you wearing?
Yeah.
Bro, you see me, like a little kid, diesel as hell, because playing soccer. Bro, I got fat in America. Like, I got super fat. Like,
yeah, me too.
Bro, like, I was like the solid kid who played soccer and was like European as hell with the Speedos. Like, you know, like me and my brother were like the night at the Roxbury. Like,
yeah.
When they were walking on the beach.
Yeah.
And I realized, like, yo, I'm doing this whole thing wrong. Like, this whole thing's messed up. My brother's older than me, so he's going through it. And we go home, and then before you know it, 2 years pass, and everything shifted. My brother started going into the city, started smoking weed, hanging out with everybody, chilling, skating. Then I started skating, and the skate culture got involved. Music got involved. Wu-Tang got involved. Jay-Z got involved.
What Biggie a time posters. To be alive,
dog.
Bro.
Did you watch that movie, Mid-90s?
Bro, I never seen it either.
Okay, so
my is brother it a doc used to or a movie?
It's a movie. My brother used to hang the hats on the wall the same way that kid hung posters. And it used to be so hip hop, Nintendo games, and like super hip hop. Like he had a boombox. He'd be playing like all the shit that was hot. So we'd go to Coney Island Ave and church, and my brother would buy these Hot 97 mixtapes, Volume 1.
It was
from Volume 1 to like, yes.
Yep. Like the bridge, all that
crazy.
Shit.
Crazy. Yeah, so all the hot shit that was like hot of that like summer was on these CDs. So it was the first time ever I go with him to go buy the CD and we get robbed at gunpoint, middle of the night. Gun gets drawn on us. That's how I knew. I was like, okay, it's time to get used to this New York shit, you know? Yep. The kid rolls up in a pink bike, little kid's bike, takes the gun out, puts it on my brother's belly, and goes, give me your money. We get robbed.
Classic.
My brother's holding on to the fucking Jay-Z CD in the back of his pocket.
What? Do you remember which one it was?
I think it was Blueprint.
Oh, my God.
So the best album. And sitting there, I'm like, damn, this is all happening in the summer. Like, we watched it. We witnessed my first stabbing.
Yep.
Like, with an ice pick. The kid I still speak to.
What the fuck?
Like, right in the chest. Like,
did you ever?
Crazy.
He got stabbed right in his chest. With an ice pick?
Oh, bro. Man. Like, crazy. For a bicycle, man. Bro. Like, this is the crazy New York life that I'm like, this is what we came through. Boom. But, like, when we first came to America, man, like, we lived in a shelter. Like, it was like super difficult because my parents were like, we're going to get you to school. We're going to get you a better life. And in my head, I'm like, I hate planes. Since a kid, I'm not getting on a plane. And they were like, you're going to meet Michael. You're going to meet Michael.
Oh, that's and evil.
I know.
That's evil.
Yeah. So like, you're going to meet Michael. You're going to meet all your favorite artists. You're going to come here. And then I'm like, all right, cool. So I get on a plane. I come through and we're in a shelter. From Germany, because I lived in Germany.
Was Michael there?
No, nobody was
there. And it was way too early for you to be popping beans too, bro. You were like, how old were you?
Yeah, exactly. So I'm sitting on a plane all messed up, dude. But yeah, man, like I came here. We was in a shelter. We were trying to find a way to like really get our first apartment. My dad got a job at a synagogue and we stayed at the synagogue for a little bit. And then we got our first apartment. One bedroom, five of us. We split the rooms with sheets. So my sister could have her own room. I had my own room. And I just always wanted a better life. So I would skate to the suburbs and try to be friends with all the rich ass kids. And like, and they'd show me like a different lifestyle. Like, yo, bro, you could be living this. Like, you know, they show me art and be like, this is how much this art is. I'm like, that piece of shit costs $3 million. So I would learn all these things, man. And before you know it, went to school, dropped out, went to college. And then that's when everything changed, man. When I went to college and I worked on, like I said, I was recording on Cudi beats. And then I went to the studio and started linking up with French Montana.
Hell yeah.
And I was working with this guy named Austin Rosen. And he kind of introduced me to a bunch of people. And then I met Nipsey. And I did a first record ever with Nipsey, my first feature. And he was like, yo, man, you should just drop out. And at the time, to me, Nipsey was like one of my favorite rappers. And so like him telling me to drop out, I dropped out. I dropped out, but the CD I put out, I didn't get signed off of it. So I dropped out, I got kicked out of my house, and I was like homeless for 2 years, sleeping in New York with a big jacket. Selling CDs. And
you lived on the streets or
just in shelters and
shit? Wow. Do you ever fall into the drug culture? Do you have to hustle and shit at any point? Or like,
yeah,
or
I mean,
you stay out of it?
I mean, you know, everyone around me, I've kind of saw it falling apart and shit. Like, you know what I'm saying? A lot of kids are doing drugs around me. And like, you know, I got to a point where I was doing drugs. 2013, I was doing so much drugs because I wanted to die. And that's kind of fucked up, but it's the truth, you know what I mean? I did want to die. 2013, I hated my life because here comes a kid, full scholarship. I'm in college. I'm fucking mad, bitches. I'm living my life, and this is amazing. And then you drop out, and you're a nobody, and everyone who, like, showed you love when you were lit kind of disappears. You're not lit. As soon as you're in a bad position, it feels like everyone disappears. You're just alone. When everyone's down on you, no one's around, bro. Like, it's super dark. And I felt like I just didn't want to live here. Like, I didn't want to be on Earth no more, so I was like popping everything I could get my hands on. And then some weird shit happened where my mom called me and she was like, hey, I lost my job. I need your help. So I moved back in and was helping my mom out. And I was hustling, getting money, whatever. And because my parents are everything to me. Like, just to, like, I know kids out there that say they hate their parents and shit. And this generation is just weird as fuck. But like, both of my parents did everything they could to get me here. So I owe them my life, you know what I mean? So when she hit me with that, I was like, I got to help her out. So I went back, I hustled, did what I did for her. And then she was like, you need to register back to school. So I was going to go to this place called Kingsburg Community College. Mm-hmm. And I was going to register that Monday. But the Sunday night, she got a call because she was like watching, like babysitting. For money.
Oh, yeah, watching kids.
Kids and stuff. And she said, can you drive me? My mom don't drive. She was like, can you drive me to the spot? And it was Sunday and I was driving. And while driving, my song came on the radio the day before I was going to quit music and go back to school. The song came on the radio. It was a guy named Peter Rosenberg.
Of course, bro. Peter Rosenberg, damn, dude.
Yeah.
Shout out Pete Rosenberg. Yeah, it was him and what was it? Hot 97, but who was he on with?
Cypher, right? Yeah, he played it, man. Yeah. I was like, holy shit. Like, I pulled over to the side of the road, and I looked at my mom, like, she's not this slick to play this, like, on me.
You thought it was a joke.
I thought it was a joke. So yeah. I was like, man, like, you shouldn't be joking like this. I'm going through it right now. And then I looked over, and I said, Mom, I hope you're not playing with me right now. And she's like, what are you talking about? I was like, this is my song. She was like, is it your song? I was like, yeah. And I started changing the stations, and it was my song.
Damn. Yeah,
and I started crying, wow, bro. Like, bro. I started crying like a little bitch, man. Like, it's called Who Made Me. And I got fired from my job. I had a job at Billabong, man. Fuck them. And
are they still in business?
I don't know. Fuck them. They trash. They sell like $150 board shorts. Like, dog, like, y'all trash as fuck. I hate y'all. Like, bro, like, I was working for them and they fired me. And I took the last check and recorded that song. And they're going to probably come after me for that song. But luckily,
you probably won't get a sponsorship, bro. Yeah, but like, fuck it is what it is. I don't think you need it.
Yeah,
now. Haley's sitting there like, damn, we got Billabong online too right now.
but I got fired. Took my last check, made that song that was on the radio. So hearing that song on the radio didn't get me a deal or anything. But what happened was it made me, like, the next day not register. I woke up and said, fuck school.
Yeah, for sure.
And
yeah.
I said, fuck school. And I was like back in the chasing the game.
Yeah, because by the way, to get that kind of acceptance from the New York hip hop scene, bro, that's like crazy, dude. Yo. Like people will not understand that if they're not from there, but like Cypher, Rosenberg, Funk Flex, all that shit, bro. If you get a record on with them, dude, it's over, bro.
It's a wrap.
Yeah.
You know, like that's such a big cosign.
Yeah.
How did that happen? Did you find out?
So a bunch of kids on Twitter attacked Rosenberg.
Always.
And was like, this is the hottest song from a New York artist right now.
Oh, okay.
So he's
spun see that
it.
A lot. You see that sometimes. Yeah. People be like, yo, why are you not playing this fucking
like,
song?
That's how Meek Mill got signed to Rick Ross because everyone from Philly attacked Rick Ross. Like, he was like, I need to sign a new artist. And everyone was like, from Philly, it's like, Meek Mill.
Yeah. Shit.
So everyone from New York was like, this is the hottest artist right now in New York. You need to play him. Mm. So he played me. And it was sick because I was on MTV that week. Sway and Busta Rhymes co-signed me. It was like everything was on a roll. I didn't get my deal yet. And I was like, damn, I still don't get my deal. But I'm going to continue to work towards it. Not going to school. I recorded this song called Room 4. And before you know it, man, I got my first record deal. Boom. This is a guy named Jason Flom. He's like, I'm going to sign you real quick. So his son discovered me. Yeah. So he signed me for like 5 G's. And...
by the way, was probably the dopest shit that's ever fucking happened. Yeah, that's what I'm saying.
Bro,
yeah.
You know how much like fucking, you know how many Popeye sandwiches you get with $5,000?
Or do you know how much shit you'd have, how much fucking grimy work you'd have to put in to get 5K on the street,
bro? Oh my God,
bro?
But like, yo, bro, I got $50,000 in my bag right now.
Crazy.
You know what I'm saying?
Yeah. Crazy my shit goes.
My little Prada bag that's with me got 50 G's in it.
Wait, hold on. You're talking about right now?
Yeah. Right now.
Why?
Like, what I'm saying is like, what's $5,000? Think about that. What's $5,000? Not to throw shade. I'm just saying, like, no kid should sign for $5,000. You should get $5,000 to kid to show up at the meeting.
But at that time, bro, that five let's put it this way. That 5K will mean more to you in your life than the next 500 you make.
You have 50K in that bag right there.
Yeah, like, yeah. Like,
prove it.
Oh, here we go. Like, no,
we don't.
No, there's no way.
Bro, stop.
He goes, no, stop.
It's only cash in that bag?
No, not only cash, but yeah, like, majority.
Bro, shut the fuck. Yeah, like, show the camera.
No, like, that's 50. I got, don't try me when you see me. Like, don't try me. I'm not setting myself up.
Hey, he's only doing it because he's in LA. If he was on a New York podcast, never. He'd be like, I got fucking fluff in this bag or some shit. Nothing. Yeah.
Why do you have $50,000 with you?
Because, you know.
No, man.
It's just fun.
It's flex money.
Man, it's not flex money. It's just like, it's just fun. Like,
you might go to the strip club tonight. Who
exactly.
Knows?
You just never know who needs cash.
Yeah. The valet
dude. By the way, hold on. By the way, at Rock Nation, I'm the valet's dude's favorite person because I'm the only one who tips. And no shots thrown at any Rock Nation artist, but I'm the only one that tips guy. And he drops everybody's name and he tells me who doesn't. So
does Lenny tip?
Yo,
does
Lenny tip?
Sure Lenny tips. Yeah, bro. Yeah. Lenny's a good guy.
But yo, I got a lot of cash because, you know, I'll be at Vegas. I just signed my residency to Marquee.
Hey, congrats.
Thank you so much.
Fuck.
Shout out to Mike.
Mike Snedegar?
Mike Snedegar. Yeah. Right.
That's my guy.
We like that guy.
Yeah, that's my guy. And I did one show. Shout out to Lenny. He made that happen. And I did one show. Man, Lenny made a lot of things happen. Shout out to Lenny for making my Nike commercial happen too.
Same Lenny still, yeah?
Lenny,
at Rock Nation. I've been trying to replace that couch. He won't let me.
No,
you know, because I've worked with a furniture brand for a long time. Yeah. Like, let me send you a new couch. That gold couch is never fucking leaving Lenny's office. I sat on that shit and I'm like, I want to replace this shit so bad.
That gold
bad,
room's
bro.
Lit though, man.
That's, yo, that's the best room lit. There, bro. Love going.
Shout out to Lenny, man. I just signed my residency in Vegas. I've been making a lot of bread and I'm thankful for it.
Yeah, for sure.
But let's get fast forward, you know. Pew. I wanted to sign a Jay-Z because I'm from Brooklyn and it was like a dream to sign a Jay-Z. Mm. When I was fucking trash, when I was homeless, I collected a dollar off of everyone online to get their book decoded by Jay-Z signed. I collected a dollar from everyone online, waited online, and I said, I'm going to put my CD in the book. When he opens it, he's going to sign me. That's just how it's going to happen. Mm. Okay. So check this out, Logan. Waiting online. Finally get there. It's just me and Jay. I'm looking at Jay. Jay's looking at me. Security guard's right next to him. This is how I get my deal in my head. I'm like, he's going to open the books and grab him. I'm like, yo, what? This is a sick CD. I'm signing you.
I'm signing you.
So in my head, I'm like, this is what's going to happen. He's going to sign me. So I get there. I'm like, hey, what's up? He's like, what's up? I'm like, yo, what's up, man? I'm a.
Oh, it's impossible, bro.
I can't even talk.
Yeah, of course not. Sure.
It's like when you're in a dream and somebody's chasing you and you're trying so hard to run, but you can't run. Bro, I couldn't even say shit. But I just said, like, I'm an artist. I'm from Brooklyn.
And he's like, and?
He's like, what's your name? And I'm like, Gashi, Larry. And he's like, cool. He opens the book and he sees the CD. He grabs the CD. Whoa, this is the moment. He grabs the CD, goes, ha, that's awesome. Throws it in the garbage.
No.
Yeah.
Jay.
Yo, throws it in the garbage, dog. And signs my shit and gives me the book back. And I'm like, this is the best moment of my life.
Like, even still with that.
Because he touched the CD.
Yeah.
Like,
but it's so funny because you think back to him and Dame rolling around in the 97 Lexus selling fucking Reasonable Doubt copies to people.
You have
and then he gets a CD and he's just like, fuck this shit, bro.
Damn.
Bruh. He threw this shit out. I was happy and like, you know, you're happy and you're crying at the same time. Like, that's the moment.
Yeah.
Like, I was just like, what the fuck just happened?
Dame, like, Dame just went on No Jumper. You know Adam and No Jumper.
Yeah, yeah. I didn't know Jumper.
Oh, you did?
Yeah.
Shout out Adam. Shout out No Jumper. Adam, yeah. He had Dame Dash on it. Turned into this big controversy the other day because I guess he paid Dame $500 to come on the show.
Oh my god.
Dame Dash, the CEO of the ex-CEO of Rockefeller Records, bro.
Who said that?
No, it's a known thing.
Fact.
Yes, Dame's even said it to pay for the car to get there and a haircut.
Oh my god.
And yo, what the fuck happened, bro?
Hold on. Can we bring my friend Gotti, who watches every podcast and knows everything
about it?
Come here.
Put the mic up.
This is my first artist.
That's not him. That's our producer, Dylan.
No, this is not
him. He's also from Brooklyn.
He's the man, by the way. You know what, man? There's nothing cooler than when you're rolling up to a podcast or a crib and people are welcoming.
Oh, yeah, for sure.
When you act like you're the Supreme store, that's how you get fucked up. You know what I'm saying?
First of all, shirt, bro, he didn't even need to say a word to me. I was like, I already like this guy a lot, bro.
So this is my friend Gotti. We've been friends from Brooklyn, and he recently started doing music, and I signed him as a songwriter.
Congrats, bro.
He's incredible. What's your opinion on the, did you see this Adam
thing?
Yeah,
talking to the mic too when you come out.
You can tilt it down.
Yeah, I was wondering, like, is it a loss for Adam or Dame? Like, that's the question we were talking about in the car. Like, who's it corny for? Dame or Adam?
Because we've never paid a single guest to come on the show, and I never will.
Yeah, like.
Andre just asked us the other night.
You're right, but. Why would he, like, bro, at $500, wouldn't you just be like, yo,
easy. What made him try to expose him? Like, what was that about?
No, I think it got out some other way. Adam said it. Adam's open about shit, bro. He doesn't beat around the bush. He's one of those dudes that just straight up says what he wants to say.
Which is why it's not, in my opinion, corny for Adam.
Because he
doesn't give
Dame.
A fuck.
Yeah, of course. 100%. Because here's the thing.
And you're taking $500.
Here's my question. Don't you just do it for free? Like, did someone just fall? What's good?
Nah.
Oh.
But hold on though, man. Yeah. I think we should end this conversation because this is a lot of chatty patty. You know what I mean?
Oh, are we fucking up?
No, that's what Dame Dash says.
Yeah.
Whenever people are talking about him, it's chatty patty.
That's what he said on the sheet. Was like, you don't know? I don't fucking know. He gets in that shit where no one knows.
It's chatty patty, okay? And we're not going to talk about that.
But right? Like, why? How bad could things be? Could things be that bad? Like, he rolled up in a short sleeve button down with a tie on. People are like, yo, this motherfucker looked like a high school teacher. But yo, like, for me... For me, when I see this shit, I'm like, yo, that's Dame Dash. That's a god.
A high school teacher.
You got to pull it up.
Oh, my God.
But like,
$30,000 a year.
How bad could things be that he had to do that?
Oh, my God. Yo.
Oh, my God.
This is crazy.
Like, is that fucked up on Jay's part for letting this happen? Because they had a huge falling out,
you know,
obviously,
what?
Right?
Let me say something, man. I'm going to say this. I have no comment on this, okay?
And I think without Dame Dash, there would be no Jay-Z.
No.
So you got to show him respect.
That's what
you
I'm
know?
Saying.
I
have no comment on this, okay? So
plead the
this
tip.
Is a bunch of chatty patty.
In this room, we call that treading lightly.
Yeah. Listen, we're going to cut that part out.
Hey, you got the PR team.
Hold on. My publicist is... going crazy right now. Like, cut it out. No, but look, man, I know about that. So I got to watch that, actually. But going back to what I was saying is, man, before the Chatty Patty, we got...
I guess pull it off the fucking screen.
The outfit was trash. But man, long story short, bro, I did the song. I came out. I had a warrant for my arrest, okay? I'm not going to say what I did. It was something really bad. And it was over a parking spot in New York, not the Bronxdale. And it was the dumbest shit I could have done. I got in trouble. I had a warrant for my arrest, and I had to fly out. I flew out to Iceland. I did some shows there because I have a fan base there, and I made money. And then I took that money, used my brother's ID, and flew out to L.A. And I'm staying low. Key out there, my friend Rory, Brad, John, who worked with Tyler, the Creator, YG, at the time, they were like, we're going to manage you. We managed to launch. I go into this house, and it's this. I meet this girl named Ella Mae. She popped off now. And it's me and Ella Mae, new artist in their Ceremony of Roses company. And they're going to manage me. I'm going to pop off. I'm around Tyler. I'm around YG. This is crazy. You know, I'm staying quiet. I'm a fly on the wall, just watching everything. And I don't pop off. They got me on YG's tour carrying Donald Trump pinatas. And I'm watching YG beat up Donald Trump pinatas every night on tour. It's called the Fuck Donald Trump Tour. Yeah. And I'm watching this happen every night. I'm carrying pinatas that are fucking big as hell. I'm carrying them on stage, and this is my job. I thought I was supposed to be like this big superstar. That's why you signed me. Like, you got me carrying Donald Trump pinatas, bro. Imagine, this is hell right now. Donald Trump pinatas, bro. Like, that's what you brought me out to LA for? I'm like, fuck this shit, dog. I dip on them. I'm out. I said, I'm done with this. I pack my shit up, and I'm couch surfing now in LA.
What year was this?
This was...
I had to be recent. Semi-recent.
2016?
Yeah.
Yeah.
But I thought I was going to get on in 2015 because I did a song with Travis Scott. I did a song with Quavo. I did a song with DJ Snake. I thought I was going to be on.
That should be enough, right?
Yeah. Yeah. Like, yo, bro, who you know does a song with Travis Scott and does the garbage
yeah.
in Brooklyn? I was yeah, a garbage yeah. man, bro. Think about it. I'm in Brooklyn stressed. That's how I got in trouble. Like, let's talk about how I got in trouble real quick before we get into to what I was just talking about. I got in trouble because my life was stressful, and I was wearing a ski mask, so nobody knew me. That's why the ski mask is alive. That's why I wear a ski mask.
While you were doing garbage
doing
shit.
The garbage. Yeah. I was a garbage man,
because you didn't want people to know that you...
It was me. Yeah, yeah. My mother told me, wear a ski mask. Nobody will know it's you. But kids started finding out it was me, and they would take pictures and post it. Like, how does this kid have a million views, has a song with Travis Scott, is like lit, but not lit because he's still doing the garbage in the hood.
Did you try going back at him and be like, yo, do you guys understand how good the compensation package is? I have a 401k. I've got health insurance. Nah. Like, what the fuck are you guys saying right now?
No, because like that's like sanitation garbage. I was doing the garbage to live for free in buildings.
As like the super?
Yeah, that's shit, where I was. I was a super.
Shout out to all the people that's living as supers right now. Yeah, shout out. Tricky like, shit, like, bro.
You know what I mean? Yeah. That shit sucks,
hell
bro.
Yeah, bro.
So no insurance, nothing. I was just living for free. And I was on food stamps. And I was just telling you yesterday,
it's crazy.
I can't believe, bro, 2016, I was on food stamps, bro. Like,
as we're driving to Malibu to go eat.
Yeah, like I'm driving to Malibu, like
going to Nobu and shit.
Yeah, which I'm going right after this. Yeah. I told my boy, I said, yo, Gotti, like, we're driving? I was like, bro, I was on food stamps, 2016. Done. No account. I didn't have a credit card, dog. Like, I didn't even know how to work that thing. I didn't even know nothing, dog. I was broke as dishes, bro. Like, what the fuck? Like,
by the way, only 3 years after what you were doing in 2013, too. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
Like, people, whenever people watch the show, I always try to tell that story about keeping that fucking fire lit.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? And don't let it go out because shit just changes.
Yeah, but
bro.
It's
you
different.
Just gotta you got to keep rolling.
But it's crazy because, like, in 2013, when I was on the street, and it was raining, and there'd be like somebody coming up to me and be like, yo, I'll let you sleep in my house if I can watch you shower naked. Right?
Wait, what?
Yeah.
That's like nasty ass people. Bro.
Yeah.
Like nasty dudes and shit.
Yeah. Like if I could watch you shower naked, like I'll let you sleep in my house. like things like that. And it'd be nights where I'm like, yo,
I almost have to do it.
I might have to do this because it's snowing. You know what I'm saying?
I'm gonna die out here.
Cause like bro, I got banned from every gym in New York.
Why?
Cause I'd go and shower and pretend I want
Yo, that's what I was saying to the van girl. It's like
we just had a girl on the other day who does that now. What's she's a member of gyms in LA because she lives in a van.
She's a 21-year-old girl. She's really pretty. And she does that. And I asked her if she got like banned. She apparently, if you get a membership, you can do that.
Yeah, I had no membership. Okay. I was going there, act interest.
You did it interested. The Brooklyn. You did it the Brooklyn way.
Same thing with Whole Foods. I carry a one fork and go in Whole Foods, fill it up, eat it while I'm waiting online.
You're hustling like that. Yeah.
Like that in LA.
Bro, that community in New York and in LA, like that community of like living by just those little tricks and it's a whole fucking world, bro, of showering a certain way, bringing a fork to Whole Foods, getting a meal here, a blanket there. People live years and years and years, decades on that type of lifestyle.
Which
people
sucks.
Just don't, it sucks.
Which sucks it really sucks, bad. Yeah. Like, you don't want to be doing that shit. You know what I mean?
It wasn't doing anything.
Like the thing is like, you don't, that lifestyle sucks, but it comes back to what, when I just said to you, I was like, yo, I was on food stamps. You're like, but you were broke in 2013 too. Yeah, but check this out. 2016, when you're in LA and there's a warrant for your arrest and you can't come back to New York, when you're in New York and you're broke, you have homies. You can call and be like, yo, let me shower at your crib real quick. I'll call my friend Noam, was like, yo, let me take a shit. You know what I mean? I'll run, take a shit. He's like, damn, bro. And I'll be out. Like, you know what I'm saying? Like, it's just the way it is. Like, you live this lifestyle, but you got your connects. You got your ex-bitches.
That one you have to fall
back. Like, yo, what's up? Let me slide through.
Sleep in your car,
exactly.
Whatever.
Exactly. You make a move. You finesse it. You find a way. When you're in LA and you don't know nobody. Bro, there was times where I slept in party houses, like mansions in the hills, and random dudes with cocaine in their nose, they'd be trying to wake me up, like, yo, let me suck your dick.
What the fuck?
Like,
that doesn't surprise me.
Bro, random dudes. Like, I'd be like, you know, you shot, you're dead. You're like, oh, fuck, I'm dead. Like, this is the first time me sleeping. Like, yo, wake up. Like, yo, what's good? Like, yo, let me suck your dick.
Yo, what
like,
the fuck?
It's so funny because
eyes wide shut.
Yeah, in New York, they come up to you, wake you up. They're like, yo, give me everything you have.
Out here,
they're like, hey, is there any chance I could suck your dick really quick?
You're like, what the fuck is good, like, close your eyes and picture it's a girl.
We'll give you everything we have instead.
Bro, it's like crazy, bro. Like, yo, the shit that I went through, like, when I first came to LA, like mentally, I'm fucked just thinking about it, you know? Like, I came out here, like, I was going through all that. I was at, like, a crazy session. Where like everybody's doing blow in front of me. I never like seen this like crazy, like people in suits that like are like respected, like doing mad cocaine and stuff. And I'm just like, damn, this is life, you know, in LA, you know?
Oh, but, it is.
But like, you know, I had to figure it out, man. This is when my life changed. I was here, I go to a party, right? And it was this dude named Detail. Fuck that guy, you know what I mean?
It's one of those.
Like, yeah, like, those guys, like he wrote for Beyonce, he wrote big songs, but fuck that dude, you know what I'm saying? Because I was dating this girl, and then when we broke up, she was in his session, and she got raped by him. So, like I don't respect that.
Hell
like,
no, bro.
Like, I don't co-sign that. That's just fucking whack.
Did he get in trouble, or is it under the radar?
I think he is, and if he's not in trouble, if you ever see him, swing on him. Swing on them. That's it. Because that shit's messed up. Like, you know, I had my first girl out here in LA and it didn't work out. And I'm in Starbucks using the Wi-Fi and I read that she got raped by this dude. And it broke my heart. And I haven't spoken to her. I tried to reach out. It's like she disappeared after the story. I think she went back to Sweden or some shit, wherever she was from. But like I was dating for her for a few months and that dude, this is before that happened. I got invited to the party. I met these producers there and they invited me to their crib and I was not even supposed to go, but I was living out of my friend's Rory's Prius and I was driving and they're like, yo, you gonna come? And I was like, oh shit, I had that session. So I busted left. How weird is that? I'm driving the same block I was supposed to be on. This is how you know things are meant to be. I bust a left, I go upstairs, and I run into their bathroom. I'm just sitting there using their Wi-Fi, taking a shit for like an hour and a half. They knock on the door.
For the shit too, or just the Wi-Fi?
Both.
Oh, that's...
So I'm sitting there taking the shit. I swear, I told them the story yesterday. Yeah, right?
And we were with them yesterday. Yeah. And they're like, we were knocking on the door.
They're like, we were knocking on the door. We thought he was like jerking off.
Yeah.
And I was like,
no, it's one of those scrolling shits where you're not pooping the whole time. Yeah. Like you're sitting there, you're on Instagram doing whatever.
Exactly. I feel, like I if the battery died, I'd be reading like the air frame.
French name ingredients.
Just because you're comfortable, bro. You're chilling.
Exactly.
You're chilling.
Like,
bro.
Legs all numb and shit.
Yeah,
I'm
you
all
leave. You got
up.
Those big indents on the back of your legs
so,
and shit.
Exactly. I'm all fucked. You know, I get out. I'm like, yo, my fault, dude. They're like, yo, the studio's right there. So I walk into the room, and the first song I record is a song that changes my life forever. I recorded this song called Disrespectful. I record it. I'm driving to Crave. I pull over. I go into Crave, and I'm looking at the menu, and I'm like, shit, I can't afford anything on this menu. And the dude, Albert, shout out to Albert, that works there, goes, yo, man, I got you. I'm gonna look out for you, man. And hooks me up with some food. And
is that our crate?
Yeah.
Really?
Yeah. He goes there. Yeah. Shout out to Akel Twins.
Yeah.
Oh my
shout
God.
Out to Crave,
bro.
Man.
Wow.
So I love Crave, man. I co-sign it. I'm there all the time. I met Machine Gun Kelly there. I met some
a lot
of the artists
people
there.
Go there, bro.
Yeah. So I get my meal. I go back in my car. I turn on the song I just recorded. It sounded super lit. And I'm just sitting in my car and I'm like, where am I going to sleep tonight? And I'm just, bro, LA gets cold, bro.
Yeah. Yeah.
So I'm just sitting there and I'm like, bro, I'm about to just like, I don't know what move I'm gonna make. And my mom calls me. The case got dropped for what I did. And I'm like, amazing. So now I gotta figure out a way to book my flight and I have no money. So I was fucking this bitch from New Jersey. And she's like, I was like, yo, what's up, man? I wanna come and see you. So she booked my flight to go see her. And she goes, what do you need? I said, book it to JFK.
Should have gone to Newark.
Exactly. Yeah. She booked me to JFK. And this bitch was waiting at the airport. I was like, yo, I'm sorry. If you see this, I'm sorry. I got the money for you. It's in my bag. Yo. So she books it and I see her at JFK. I duck this bitch. I hop in the cab.
Oh no, shit.
I go straight home.
Oh my God.
Bro, God forgive me. I'm so fucked up. Yo, I still saw her though. You know what I'm saying? But I just did not see her that day. So we ended up I ended up going home. I see my mom. I hug my mom, hug my family, my sister, everybody. And then they're like, so tell me, like, you've been gone for a while. Like, what have you been doing? And I said, I've been recording, you know, keeping it, you know, low key in LA. I said, play me the song. So I played the song, Disrespectful, that I recorded. I play it and I start dancing to it while playing it. My mother records me. And she goes, post it on Instagram. Bro, we posted it and went viral.
What it get? From remember?
400,000 views.
Just being a catchy song?
Just dancing
and
to the
you were happy.
And I was happy as fuck. And I'm boom. And I think I took it down, but I could send it to you because I archived that thing.
Oh, he'll find it.
The song is called Disrespectful.
Can I play a little bit right now?
Yeah, let's do it. The song went viral and the song that changed my life. Right here on Logan Paul. Podcast. Disrespect me, and I'm real disrespectful. Damn.
This is tight.
Hey, disrespect me. The weird shit is the raps I said down here came to life. I'm posted with my clip, we ain't never flinch. Credit card work the wrist, LeBron with the chip. All the sauce made a slip, when I walk I drip. We don't care that you rich, you corny low bitch. I started all the vibes, started all the waves. Could've made it in my country, took it to the States. I'm feeling like I'm ace, switch it up. Let's go. Moving it quick, trying to get rich and I'm dodging these sticks. Got hit in the Uber, they call me a lift. She pissed, what it is. Girl, I'm stuck up in my ways, yeah. You can call me when you naked. Excuse me, respect the motherfucking set. Bottle service, cause you know we love to flex. Money double up when I fuck a check. Bitch, I got now, fuck who got next. Seen you from afar.
Yo, what the fuck? I didn't know these headphones had that much bass, man. It's good, yo.
What the fuck? Hey, shout out to Logan Paul for being the best DJ in the world.
Let's go, bro.
I'm quick with it.
That was unplanned, bro.
Yeah, so that shit really changed my life. Thank you for playing that, man. That reminded me where I came from. You know what I mean?
Hey, if I didn't do it then, I was going to do it after the show. I always love seeing that moment or that piece of work that flips someone's life. Complete 180.
That changed my life.
So sick.
Thank you so much.
So dope.
Man. Disrespectful changed my life. I said, oh, shit. Guess who wants to meet me? Rock Nation, Jay-Z. Okay, go, boom. Dude. Signs to Jay-Z. Woo! Clap it up for that one.
Hey, let's go.
Hey, did you ever tell Jay-Z the story of him throwing the CD out?
No, I haven't, but I'm sure he's seen it. I saw Jay, and I said, one time we had brunch, and I said, hey, Jay, man, because I get nervous every time. So I'm like, oh, my God, Jay, what's up? How you doing? I said, it's nice to meet you again. He goes, you can only meet me once.
So, yeah, so yeah, no, yeah, yeah.
You can you, see him yo, after you, that.
Exactly.
Nice to see you.
Yeah.
Nice to see
that's
you.
That's my go-to. My go-to.
Do you think is there anybody nowadays that's rapping or anybody that you would meet that you'd have that same? Because like I think about that moment. I've gotten close to him. I did Made in America with him. Uh-huh. I did some brand shit with him, and I got access to his Beyonce's and the family's little private area in the back.
Yeah.
And I got close enough to say something to him. Yeah. And I had the same. I'm like.
How tall is he? He's pretty tall.
Tall
too.
As fuck.
Oh, he's tall.
He's standing with Beyonce. Yeah. Standing with Beyonce and the kids, and I'm like,
No.
I waited for that moment my whole life. There's nothing to say. Yeah. What am I gonna say? Hey, hope you like the fucking beanbag chairs.
It's over. It's over.
What the fuck is going on? You don't give a shit.
It's a wrap. Okay, so I'm there now, and I see him, and I'm just like, hey, what's up? We have good conversations, and. Then I'm like, okay, signed to management with Jay-Z, Roc Nation. And then I got another viral moment.
Nice.
I go to, I got 15 record labels trying to sign me. All indie and all record labels.
That's the best.
Yeah, and I'm excited because I used to walk into these rooms and I used to be like, how do I look? And now it gets to a point when you have a nice record, you're like, you used to walk into these rooms, you're like, I hope they like me. And now you walk into these rooms and you're like, I hope I like them.
Yes.
You know what I'm saying? Things change, you know? So you're like, fuck these people, you know? So whatever, man, I walked to this room and I turned up on AS. And they didn't want to give me the money I wanted. And then I ended up signing for $3 million. And
let's go.
RCA Records.
Oh my God. That's
you guys want to see the other viral video? I think I left it up. Yeah. Let's watch this one. So it goes viral and I get all my following from this video. And nobody really cares about me.
Is it down here?
Scroll down a little more. A little more. Right there, middle.
Middle?
Yep. This is me at RCA.
Oh, shit. Yo, you turn up like this at the label?
Yeah.
Who is that behind you? Is that Dre?
That's Mark Pitts. Oh, that's who signed Biggie.
I thought it was what's his name
he
from Post.
He signed me.
Yo, so one of these old white folks are just looking at you like, like this guy's music is actually great. And you're just in the zone?
Yeah, yeah.
Actually, like, bro, I love watching the old white dudes.
They're like, this is lit.
Look at this guy.
Oh, go back.
And then there's one right here, too. He's just like, wow. Arms crossed. He's like, this ain't half bad, guy.
Go back for a second, dog.
I wish Instagram put that feature on. I can't rewind,
man.
We have to restart it again. Instagram, fix this shit, okay? Watch this. This is a crazy pound. Everybody points this out. Watch this pound. Ready?
Watch this.
Psych!
Oh, you swerved this dude so... He was just trying to be hip. He was just trying to be cool with the new artist. He just fucked him. Shit. Completely missed him.
Damn. Yo, hold on.
The old white dudes. Hold I on. Love them.
So that's what happened. I went viral again. Go up a little bit.
That's not what we look like when we bopped your shit, is it?
Nah.
It is fucking it.
No, it's not. No, it's not.
Hey, listen, you can come to our house in Connecticut, man, anytime.
Play that one right there.
Jimmy
Fallon? Yeah, this went viral too.
Oh, I'm so excited.
Because I'm the first artist to jump into the crowd. No one's ever done that.
Oh, Fallon?
On Fallon?
Yeah. That's me. This is not... Look.
Oh, shit.
Look.
Damn. Oh, so you're just permanently like ready to be lit.
Yes.
You're like lit on standby.
Yes, yes. So only reason why I went into the crowd is because my mom's first time watching me perform. So I wanted to go hug her. So I just ran into the crowd.
Sick. That's sick.
And yeah, man.
What was that like for her?
It was amazing. She cried, man. She can't believe it. She still can't believe it, man. The first check I got with Disrespectful before I signed to RCA was $200,000. Shout out to Spotify and shout out to Too Money. Hell put me on Rap Hell Caviar and changed my life. And I grabbed that money and I moved my mom to her first home. That's the first thing I did.
Right.
And
my life has been going up. Not where I want to be, but I'm not where I used to be, you know?
Yep.
And now I'm on Logan Paul podcast, baby. We lit.
You're peaking.
That's it. <You're> I hit the ceiling.
There's nothing left now, bro. Yo, you fucking made it, dude.
Go, champ.
Oh, man.
I want to do a segment real quick.
All right.
And then I want to have you perform Safety, yeah? Safety's mm-hmm. new one. All right, tight, tight, tight. But all right, this segment's called More Than 280. I love this segment. It's actually one of my favorites.
What is this?
So it... Tweets of yours.
Okay, okay.
Tweets can be up to 280 characters, but sometimes they're...
That's two tweets. They're 140.
You're a little outdated, Mark. Sure,
okay. Okay.
It's 280 now.
Yeah, well, me and you both.
I should know that.
You know, sometimes...
I love Twitter, bro. Okay.
You definitely go over 140. For sure. Yeah, man, sometimes you can't tell what's going on in the tweeter's mind with these ambiguous tweets. So I just want to pick your brain what some of these tweets meant.
Okay.
A girl is a gun.
Safety. My single. Oh. The whole time is me talking about a girl as a gun.
I guess we should have waited.
So the song is like, I need you to come over and save me. I need to put this gun on safety. So that's why I tweeted that.
Thanks a lot, sense. Dylan.
Yeah. Why is the girl a gun? Because she could either save me or kill me.
Yes.
That's so true.
Yes.
I should have asked that.
That's why I just want a baby. I just want a kid to have my kid and just raise my kid. Like, I don't want to be married.
That's
like,
what I want. What? I've been saying it for the past 6 months.
I want a thick, smart girl to have my kid so he could go to the league, be smart. And that's it. Just want to have my son.
Yo, that's what I've been saying. I wanted to play in the NBA. Yeah, NFL's a little too dangerous.
I just want to play sports.
Okay, okay.
And just be like athletic as shit. Like I want him to come out with abs.
Yeah. So you're just looking for a new way to monetize.
I'm just saying, like, if you're a girl out there and you're trying to have my baby, please slide into the DM and say I want your baby.
Also, likewise.
And get away from me after.
Same.
Yeah. So that's what that was. All
right, tight, tight. When you drop a hit record, your phone blows up.
A lot.
Yes. Safety. I just dropped Safety. Going back again. Safety is amazing. And everyone's calling me. Usually when something good happens for you, everyone calls to make sure you're still friends. Because they're like, fuck, he's really blowing up. Like, they're like, hey, what's up? I'm like, what's up? They're like, I just want to see if you're going to pick up. You know what I'm saying? Because they want to test the waters to make sure you're still cool. And I think after this record that I dropped, Safety, go get that, I'm changing my number.
Yeah. It's that time.
Yeah,
it's happening.
It's that time. Yeah, it's that time.
How long has it been since you changed it?
Well, I changed it 3 times. And now I haven't changed it in a long time. But I think after this podcast, we're changing
it. Let's go. Because it's so symbolic of when you change the number. Yeah. That's the most, that's like, yo.
I think people love you more when you ignore them.
Yeah.
When you answer it, they're like, oh, he still ain't shit. It's cool.
Yeah. Yeah.
You ignore that shit and you click it and they're like, fuck, he's on.
Yeah, you're right. When Young Thug said, fuck me, daddy, I felt that shit. what's going on here? Why did you feel that?
I don't know. I love Young Thug. You know what I'm saying? And I guess when I'm
like, I actually don't know why.
Cause hold on. I think I got a video on my phone of a girl saying that to me.
Also, shout out Thugger, highest streamed rap album of 2019, I believe he just hit on his new shit.
Yeah,
the new Young Thug album. It's got like 180.
Yeah, it's like the hottest album out right now, right?
When women say "fuck me, daddy" to you, Mike, are they saying it because it's hot or because you could potentially be their father?
Second part. Okay. Second part. Absolutely.
I can't remember the last time a girl said that to me. Actually, I can.
By the way, no one ever says
so.
That.
So that's what it's no good. It's good in like folklore that. And like sexual folklore myths.
They say it on the way into the sex. God.
She didn't say that on that one.
So you can actually swear on the show, but you unfortunately cannot place Pornhub.
No, you can. You can do whatever the fuck you want, bro.
Man, we lit, man.
That was animal.
I was really looking for it because that video is what made me say it. Like this one.
Yo, what the fuck am I watching? I wish y'all could see this. I wish y'all could see what I just saw. It's forever seared into my brain.
Hey.
I fucking love you, bro. What the fuck?
Hey. Fuck me, daddy. Yo. Hey, next tweet. Let's go. That, shout out to Young Thug, man. I love you. You my idol.
Like, that girl was thick as fuck.
How do you feel about Young Thug and about, you know, like,
I wear dresses.
Rappers rocking dresses.
I wear
when
dresses.
You come from. No, you.
I wear dresses.
I thought I said.
I wear dresses.
I don't. Why are you looking at me?
I'm hoping you can help me.
I know nothing about what you're gonna say.
How do I feel?
I was gonna say, how do you feel coming from like traditional Brooklyn, Jay? Biggie?
Yeah, I know. You know what, man? You gotta remember, man. Before I wanted to be Jay-Z, I wanted to be Prince. I wanted to be. I wanted to be Freddie Mercury.
You want people to express themselves.
Yeah, man. There's times where I do weird shit. You know what I'm saying? Yeah. And people say it's weird, but to me, it's not weird. Like I wore a dress the whole tour, right?
Yeah.
I did a dress the whole tour.
Like, I feel like I saw something about that.
Yeah, like I wear dresses. Like it's amazing. Like, bro, you know, I go to Walmart. You know the what do you call the pregnant lady dresses?
The maternity.
I think that's it. Yeah.
Those are the most comfortable things to wear on tour.
I feel like you've almost convinced me. I may take the next.
I'm telling you, if you wear one and you ought to wear one to a strip club.
Can you get some of these, Danny? I swear to God, we should rock them out.
Is it liberating?
Show.
Huh?
Is it liberating? Like, it makes you feel open and like feel good and shit.
It feels great, and you get hard. For no reason.
That's tight.
For no reason. Wear it with no underwear.
I could use
it. And go to a strip club.
I don't wear underwear anyway.
That's amazing. So then you lit. Easy. I'm telling you, once you wear that, you're like, okay, it's lit. So what Young Thug is doing, I heard he did it because he had a gun, by the way. He had a big AK.
Yeah, he had AK.
So he wanted the dress to cover that?
He was on an interview.
So that's why he's wearing a dress, because he was hiding the gun.
Yeah, by the way, number one album, Billboard 200.
He's the best.
So much fun.
Young Thugger. Slam. Holla at me. Next three. Is that what it is?
That's it.
We leave it at Fuck Me Daddy.
Yeah, okay. That's all we got. That's all we got. Okay. All right, bro. You want to go? Go sing a little bit? Sing raps, hip hop?
Man, I just want to say, I put out my single Safety. My album's coming out September 20th. And I got two albums dropping. The first album is about a guy who makes hip hop, pop music, dance music. And the second album is about me building a time machine with my friend and going to 1984. So I went to 1984 and I made an album called Nostalgia 84. This is exclusively here. No one knows about this. This album is me basically being the trap Phil Collins, being George Michael, and introducing the world to a new sound. So we made a time machine because we hate this era.
Yeah.
And we're putting out an 80s album. And it sounds 80s. It's not no samples, all original sounds.
I love that.
When you say you made a time machine, did you act? Like, did you act?
Of course he did.
We made a time machine.
Of course they did.
Just checking.
We're not really here.
We're not really here right now.
All right, tight. So September 20th, be on the lookout for that.
Yeah.
Okay.
September 20th, and then October is the 80s.
Fire.
And when I throw my 80s party, Logan, I would love for you to be there.
Yes. Is it here?
It's going to be in LA.
Let's go.
All right.
I'm there.
And
by the way, just me.
Shout out to your brother, too. Great kid. Great kid. Saw me at Crave, came up to me, was like, Gashi.
Oh, for real?
Yeah, goes, Gashi, right? And I'm like, yeah, how the fuck you know me?
You have a neck tattoo that says Gashi.
I don't think he saw it.
Okay.
And he said, because I was low-key my hoodie on. It came up to me, right?
Crave.
And he followed me and DM'd me.
What's the
and
feet?
Goes, yo.
Oh, for real?
Yeah, showed me mad love. So for a kid to be, what's that feedback? That's just trash.
It's gonna be lit.
Okay.
It's gonna be lit.
I just want to let you guys know, man, like, you know, when a kid like your brother, who's like right now, like crazy, like you guys are so fucking, like people are not talking about pop stars. People are talking about you guys. When you're at that level and a kid like that comes up to me at Crave and shows me hella love, says he fucks with me, follows me. If you're out there right now, don't fucking act crazy when you see me because you have 20,000 followers. And be like, act all bougie.
Yeah.
There's kids out here who are actually fucking lit and can't walk through Coachella. Like, I remember seeing you guys at Coachella.
Security guards.
Like,
oh, for real?
Yeah. And you guys had more people on your nuts, than the people performing there. Like what pisses me off, and they know who they are. Like, don't act Hollywood when you're not lit in real life, bitch. Shut the fuck up.
Hey, period. We've been trying to say this forever, dude. Yeah. Like, even if you have a fuckload of followers, just be a human person.
That's
like, don't suck. It's so easy to not suck.
They suck. They all suck. And that's what makes that's what made that moment so awesome. And that's why I wanted to say that. Like, he came through, showed me love, followed me, DM'd me, said, yo, man, keep going. Yeah, bro, he did that. And that was right after you guys left the fight. He took the helicopter and took Crave. Like,
oh, shit, for real?
Yeah.
Oh, damn.
Me and him have the same tattoo artist.
So okay. Thanks to him, I was able to get blasted because the guy was like, I was at the crib like tattooing this kid for like 3 days.
Yeah.
You know
yeah,
what I
yeah.
mean? So shout out to your brother, man. And shout out to people that are actually, don't forget to be a good person, man. You know what I'm saying? Support your friends. And I know this is all cool and shit, but at the end of the day, man, we're all in this together, like in this world.
Yep.
So you might as well just like be nice while you're here. Don't be a fucking jerk off.
Facts.
And that's that. Safety. I love that. Up next.
Let's go. Gashi, everybody.
Okay.
So this is no. What are you doing? Oh, sweaty ears.
What's
that? Sweaty ears.
Oh no, I didn't. Well, I thought we were moving. Are we chilling?
I mean. Dylan told us to talk for a little bit, just to buy some time. Yo, I'm gonna talk so he can't hear me, bro, because he's right over there, and I hate talking about people like about the one that's ass dude, in front bro. Of us, bro. I mean, bro,
107
touchdowns.
He got the Russian jail tats and shit, bro. It's like Easter.
My first tat was a face tat.
You ever see?
I didn't want a regular job.
Was it the four?
Yeah.
The first tat was the face tat.
You don't get a regular job after that.
Now you have to. I've seen it's that. Lit, man. I've seen that. You get a face tat.
Yo, Logan, you gonna get a face tat next.
Hey, let's go. What's up?
You gonna get a face tat.
Should I?
Yeah.
I'm gonna get a face tat.
Hey, right, are you ready for this?
What are you saying? Intro? Oh, okay.
I'm ready for this. I wanna hear your intro.
Oh, it's real simple.
Live.
Are we good?
Live on Impaulsive.
Here we go. Live on Impaulsive. Definitely live. Ladies and gentlemen, here to perform his single, Safety. It's a Gashi.
Sometimes I wanna fall in love cause I'm sick of lies. When you're not around, all I got is tears in my eyes. Mama praying, saying, boy, that you'll be fine. You're the first and the last and that's always on my mind. I need you come over and save me now. Tell them all that you love me now. Please don't you ever put me down. Make me put this gun down now. I need you come over and save me. I need to put this gun on safety. I hate that you just said you hate me. I need you come over and save me right now. Let's go, let's go.
Shout out to my bro Logan and all the people in here tonight. Throw your hands up like it's Coachella in this bitch. Hey, let's go.
Broke my heart into pieces. Never thought you would leave me. Girl, you're mine like the seasons. Switching up for no reason. Never thought you would leave me. It's so hard to redeem me. Girl, you got me spinning around it.
Let's go!
I need you come over and save me now. Tell them all that you love me now. Please don't you ever put me down. Make me put this gun down now.
Sing it!
I need you come over and save me.
Hey,
I need to put this gun on safety.
Let's go, come on.
I need that you just said you hate me.
Logan,
I need you come over and save me.
Let's go, let's go, let's go.
I need you come over and save me.
Woo.
I need to put this gun on safety.
Woo.
You just said you hate me.
Woo, woo.
I need you come over and save me.
Four, jump, jump. I love you guys so much. Thank you for supporting me. Shout out to Haley. I love you. Shout out to Rock Nation and everybody over here. Paul, you the man. Peace.
Thank you guys for watching Impaulsive, the number one podcast in the world. We love you. We'll see you next time. Subscribe. Peace.